In this video, we are going to find out if some condition is true whenever you use an automated program like this expert advisor here. You obviously need to check if something is true or false. For example, if the stochastic is above or below the dotted lines here, or if the price is above or below the moving average. And now we want to find out how to do that. Please click on the little icon here or press F4. And now you should see the Metaeditor, and here you want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file SimpleIfCondition. Now click on Continue, Continue, and Finish. Now you can delete everything that is above the onTick function. And let's also remove the two command lines here. We are going to start by using two integer variables. A is 5 and B should be 3. And if A is greater than 5, I would like to see the text. A is greater than 5. And if that is not the case, I can use the else statement. So whenever none of the conditions is true, I would like to see the text, conditions not true. So that's about it. Please click on the compile button or press F7. We don't have any errors here. Oh, I've got a warning because I forgot the command statement and now everything is okay. So let's click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to Metatrader. And in Metatrader we click on View, Strategy Tester. You could also press Ctrl and R. And here we want to pick the file SimpleIfCondition.ex5. Please enable the visualization mode here and start a test. And now we get the output conditions not true because A is not greater than 5. So let's add another if statement here where we check if A is equal to 5. Now let's recompile the code, stop the test, start a new one, and this time the output is A equals 5. Now what will happen if we add another if statement here to check if B equals 3? Let's recompile the code, start another test, and now we get only the output that B equals 3. The statement here is ignored. And what we could do now is, we could use two if statements. In the first one, we will check if A is 5. The second one will check if B equals 3. And the output will be A equals 5 and B equals 3. Let's recompile the code. And in our next test, we will get the output A equals 5 and B equals 3. So far so good, but if you add anything here, for example, we want that C equals A plus B, and we want to output the value for Z. So when we click on the compile button now, we get two errors here, and the reason is that whenever we use more than one line behind the if statement, we need to use two curly braces. So let's recompile the code, and now it works. And now in our last test, we get the output Z equals 8. This was a very basic example. There are a lot of other additional ways to check conditions, but in this little video you have learned how to check if a condition is true by using the if statement. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.